President Mahinda Rajapaksa has informed the Election Commissioner that presidential polls will be held first. Minister Gamini Lokuge told our sister website vimusuma.com. The decision to hold the presidential polls had been taken at a ruling alliance party meeting held at Temple Trees this morning. The opposition alliance has said that they will reveal its common candidate once the president announces which election would be held first. The opposition United National Front wants to know why service commanders skipped General Sarath Fonseca's farewell ceremony at Army headquarters recently.
යුගයේ අභියෝග ජයගත් ජෙනරාල් සරත් ෆොන්සේකා මැතිතුමාගේ සමුගැනීමේ උත්සවයට හමුදාපතිවරු සහ පොලිස්පතිවරයන් සහභාගී නොවන්නට අවස්ථාව උදා කළේ කවුදයි යන්න රටේ ජනතාව දැනගන්නට ඕන. එසදා රටේ ජනතාවට අයිතියක් තිබෙනවා. ඇයි එහෙම කළේ? කවුද එහෙම කළේ? යන්න පිළිබඳව ප්‍රශ්න කරන්නට එක්සත් ජාතික පෙරමුණ වෙනුවෙන් අපටත් අයිතියක් තිබෙනවා.
The Media Center for National Security earlier said that it was not compulsory for the armed forces chiefs to be present at the farewell ceremony and that the absence of them could be attributed to the fact that the farewell was scheduled at short notice. Prime Minister Ratnasiri Wickremanayake told a SAARC business conference that Sri Lanka will assist in combating terrorism if the island's expertise is sought.
When I was interviewed just a few minutes ago by a Pakistani journalist and he asked me whether we are in a position to give advice and technical know-how how to combat terrorism, I said that's entirely an internal matter of your country. That's how we consider ourselves. If help is sought, naturally help will be available. If assistance is sought, it will be available. But on our own we will not go and tender advice. That is not our job. Because we believe that we should not interfere in the internal affairs of other countries. That is one of the principles on which Bandung was formed and the non-alignment movement came to existence. Those are basic factors. But thirdly, we must help friends. If help is sought, we are there. Whatever experience we have gained in that particular field will be available.
The conference was held to promote joint business ventures between private and state sectors in the region. Minister Sarath Thamunugama says the private sector should expand to absorb unemployed youth as the government has recruited the maximum to the state sector.
We have reached the maximum when it comes to government employment. 1.2 million public servants, including the armed services, and close on 500,000 pensioners. So when we think of these nightmare commitments for consumer items which we can produce here but we are buying from abroad, this huge commitment to the public sector, burgeoning public sector, we cannot any longer hope that the public service or government can absorb these people. It's only the private sector that can answer that need. How can we address that issue? That is the primary issue in Sri Lanka. And that can be only done if the private sector expands fast enough to absorb this capacity. There's no other way.
In 2008, state workers took home 53.6% of tax revenues or 313.9 billion rupees as salaries and wages. Earlier this month, the government said it will recruit 17,000 unemployed graduates from state universities, expanding the already bloated state sector. A conceptual plan to modernize one of the oldest housing complexes in the island, the Bambalapitiya Flats, has been submitted to the government by a group of construction giants. Major and specialist constructors, a division of the National Constructors Association, is spearheading the project, which will build 15 24-story buildings on an 8-acre land.
As you know, Bambalapitiya Flats is 56 years old. We want to have a complete new development here, which consists of malls, offices, service apartments, boutique hotels, executive apartments and luxury condominiums. As you all know, Bambalapitiya Flats has a very distinct advantage that borders the sea, which has the Marine Drive, and on the other side we have the Gaul Road, and this is in between Colombo and Mount Lavinia. Therefore, we are of the opinion that this is almost the best locality in Sri Lanka, not only in Colombo.
The Bambalapitiya flats, which were built in 1958 by the government for middle-income public servants, were sold off to private investors in the late 70s. Once complete, it will house 1,200 apartments, a mall, office complex and other facilities. The miniature city-like project's cost is estimated at $1 billion. The Met Department predicts showers over the island during the next few days. Thundershowers will develop at most places in the country during the afternoon and night. Fairly heavy rainfall is likely at some places. There may be temporarily localized fairly strong winds during thundershowers. The general public is requested to take precautions to minimize damages caused by lightning.